but the hall is awash with terrific badminton. We witnessed a spellbinding mixed doubles just now. Satwik Rankireddy and Ashwini Ponapa downing the sixth seeds of Hafiz Faisal and Gloria Emmanuel Wijaya. 21-16, 71 minutes required, 72 according to that. And Busanan Ombang Rungfan prior to that coming through against Sabrina Jacquet in straight games, much more straightforward that one. Now then, next up it's an Indonesian Thai men's doubles. It's a first meeting featuring the fifth seeds, Fahar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto of Indonesia. They're world ranked number six, fifth seeds, and well, they are heady favourites, I guess you'd say, over a relatively new Thai pairing of Nitifon Phuangphuapet and Tanupat Viriyangkura, who are sort of ranked 128th in the world. But it should be fairly plain sailing in favour of the Indians. But it's sport, and, you know, anything can happen. And Phuangphuapet is a good men's doubles player. He's been up to number 11 in the world. There's where they are in the draw. Now, there's a story there because it's fairly open. Three of the top eight seeds have gone. The top seeds, Gideon and Sukumulya, couldn't make it thanks to Sukumulya catching COVID at the last minute. And the third and fourth seeds as well from Japan. The third seeds, Takashi Kumura and Kyogo Sonoda. And fourth seeds, Endo and Watanabe, also unavailable. So the winners not projected to meet another seeded duo until the semi-final. Perhaps Ellis and Langridge, somebody like that in the quarterfinals. But that sort of section of the draw is really very, very open. So opportunity abounds in this little second quarter of the men's doubles draw. All to play for. We're still awaiting the walk-on of our athletes. And you can see immediately that Jonathan Christie is grappling in his singles match with Lo Kian Yu of Singapore. Lo took the opening game, 21-13. A very talented player. I watched the Singaporean win the Thai Masters. I think it was back in 2019. He beat Lin Dan in the final. And
yes,
what a player he is. Very, very
big upset.
Yeah.
And the interesting part is that
came to qualifying as well.
Yeah, Lo is actually from Penang in Malaysia and was offered to join the sports school in Singapore when he was about 12, 13 years of age, and accepted it and has represented Singapore ever since. So that was well spotted by the Singaporean.
Yeah,
he's done well.
He really has.
Very quick on his feet.
Well, I'm told we've been waiting for the technical officials to get sanitized, sprayed down, hand gel, all of that. And they're making their way out very shortly, I'm told, to that center court, if you will, show court one. Here they come now, as we speak. It's beautiful, beautifully dressed, isn't it, this building right now, Morton? No expense spared. Over $3.5 million US dollars between the three tournaments that we'll be watching over the next 3 weeks, of course. The real big ones, these. And of course, you know, well, it's just great opportunity for all the athletes, isn't it, as well?
Yeah,
lovely to see it back.
They've been waiting for it.
Yeah.
So it's good to have badminton back in the calendar. And it would be very interesting to see how we will cope with the whole situation in the months to come. And of course we have a tour in Europe in March, and then hopefully in Malaysia in April, and in Indonesia in June.
Yeah, there was talk, wasn't there, about the whole sort of cluster theme, you know, but hopefully the vaccines will sort of supersede that and we needn't go to that. There's the man with the blue helmet.
Change of hair colour.
Alfian, absolutely, going for the blue. That really is very radical, isn't it? That's a statement hairdo that. Perhaps he's just not quite capturing enough media attention. And his partner, Mohamed Rian Ardianto, as well. they're out. And then here come the Thai pairing. Man with the heavy build out first, Nitifon Phuangphuapet, followed by Tanupat Viriyangkura, 24-year-old, 5 years younger to his partner. And, well, it should be interesting to see how this unfolds, because these two, ranking-wise, right up against it. First meeting, never played this team before. And the Asian Games silver medalists are out, keen to get on with things.
Okay, leg, raise.
Well, it's all a little bit hard, isn't it, to understand people behind the masks. It's almost like you've got to pump the volume right up. And of course, we're all habit talkers, and very few people actually do that. But these guys elected to stay at their end. 25-year-old Fahar Alfian in the blue corner, ranked at sixth in the world, they are, the Indonesians, seeded fifth. And they made seven semi-finals or beyond over the course of 2019. A very strong team. Recent results, well, Indonesian Masters semi-finals, along with the Malaysian Masters semi as well. Lost, they did play the All England Open, lost to Alison Langridge in straight games in the round of 16. Well, it's all about the start when you've not played a lot of match badminton. And these guys will be desperately keen as well to get off to a flyer. 29 years old, Nitifon, born and bred in Bangkok, has been as high as 22 in the world in mixed doubles, and as high as 11 in the world in men's doubles back in February 2015. But currently ranked with this partner down at 128 in the world. And they've, as we take a look at Tanupat Viriyangkura, 24 years old, again from Bangkok. They've yet to pass the round of 16, a feat that they've achieved three times already in their four opportunities to play together. They made the round of 16 at the Austrian Open in 2020, the Guangzhou Korea Masters, and the Macau Open in 2019 as well. Yeah. Oh, he's got the mask off now. Look, we can hear him.
Yeah, the partnership, the Thailand partnership, started in November 2019. So they haven't had a lot of opportunity to play. Phuangphuapet has won five titles in men's doubles prior to today with other partners.
There's Bert again, service judge this time. He was up first in the women's singles that we enjoyed. Ombang Runfan coming through in that one against Sabrina Jacquet in straight games, as she normally does. So that's a 4-0 stranglehold over that head-to-head that the tie number two has. Morten, what do you anticipate here? Tough one to call, isn't it?
I think that the Indonesian combination is by far the biggest favourite here. They are an awesome pair.
Yeah, they can.
They play really, really well when they play well, and they are five or six in the world. And imagine Indonesia's got two pairs better than that. They have number one and number two in the world. Such strength they have in Indonesia when it comes to men's doubles.
And given that the draw's opened up, you've got to reckon that they're sort of strong contenders for the title. The top half is really open, you know.
They're definitely contenders.
Play. The only other seeds born in the top half of the men's doubles draw is Aaron Chia and So Wuyik at eight seeds, yeah.
Yeah,
and they're right at the top.
Yeah, but that's a good Malaysian pair. They play well.
Yeah.
So,
quarterfinals of the All England Open, weren't they? Lost to the top seeds, didn't they?
So yeah, but the year before, they have been in the final.
That's right.
Two of the young Malaysians.
Yes.
They went to the final one year.
That's right.
Where they lost to the Indonesian pair.
2-1. It's going to be interesting to see how this young man shapes up.
Oh, that's a good defensive shot. Excellent.
3-1.
Really good shot from Viriyankura. Good serve again from him. An excellent start for the Thailand pair. 4-1 up. Nice follow-up from Fajr Alfian. Very, very strong player at the front of the court. And of course, there has been rumours in the past about Fajr Alfian and Kevin Sukamoyo might partner up in the future, but everyone talking about two players so strong at the front, maybe they are not suited to play together. Indonesian combination is a very strong attacking combination, but we can already see that they're struggling a little bit in terms of finishing the rallies, and the conditions is definitely favouring their Thai opponents at the moment when it comes to defensive skills. Look at that one, that's called in. Really, really fantastic drive there from Phuangphuapet. Setting up an 8-4 lead in favour of the Thailand pair.
And I guess it's difficult when you come from, you know, Indonesia, where, you know, generally it's pretty fast, isn't it, in a lot of the intimate little halls they play in over there.
Yeah, and it's definitely also warmer in Istora Senayan in Jakarta, where they're playing the Indonesian Open, the Indonesian Masters and so on.
Asian Games, yeah.
That's what we see here. The conditions are fairly cold. And that influenced the speed of the shuttle.
Well, look what it's done to his hair. Made it go blue. He's that cold. Quick to pounce.
10.
Yeah, really, really very aggressive at the net.
Yeah, good showing.
Semi-silver, 10.
Super defense. What a turnaround that was from the Indonesians. This time it was the turn of the Thais struggling to kill the shuttle.
And this time it was Ardianto, who was showing his good skills at the front of the court, really rushed that very nicely and putting it into the deep forehand corner, forcing an error. Closing the gap here, just 2 points.
No! No! 9-10.
Suddenly 10-5. Becomes 10-9, four in a row for the fifth seeds.
No! No! 10-all.
Statement badminton from the Indonesians right now. Done well to steady the ship. Well, that is some turnaround. Six consecutive points for the yellow and white clad Indonesians, and they suddenly have come to the party. They take to the front, 11-10 to the turn they go.
Defensive shots from Ardianto. Straight drive down the line. Very quick in his reactions. Now look at that once again.
I guess he's spending all that time the other side of the net from Gideon and Sukumulyo, right? Speeds you up.
But usually it's Ardianto from the back and Alfian at the front. But here Ardianto played really some good shots from the front of the court. And I said that too early. You jinxed him.
Umpire, Ivo Kassel from Switzerland. Service judge, Robertus Tommy Oscariano from Indonesia.
Yeah, good defensive play from Phuangphuapet.
12-14.
Takes over 15-12.
Service over.
Well, they seem to have sort of steadied the ship with that run of 9 consecutive points and really got the wheels back on. That was a little somehow blasé, a little bit of a miscue from Ardianto there, but thus far he's been very good. You can tell he's a man of experience, can't you? Phuangphuapet, he's so alert there in the front court, just reading the play really well. This young man's done very well too.
Considering the amount of results we have seen in the past from Viriyankura, I think he's playing really, really well. Considering he hasn't really got a lot of results to his CV, I think he's showing in this match that he's really a good player.
Electric point, both teams.
16-15.
I was watching him closely, the man you were talking about, Viriyankura, and he was really good there in defence as well, rock solid. It was his partner that
absolutely
made the error.
Yeah,
no, I stand by you there, Morton. It's a great call. He's come on a lot.
Yeah, considering you didn't know what to expect, because you look at his results in the past and look at his CV, and you look, oh, he hasn't done a lot, and he's 24 years of age and all that, and you know, I'm really positively surprised.
Perhaps he's found the right partner, do you know what I mean? They just gel well together, don't they?
Yeah.
Doing very respectably here. And of course, during the quarantine lockdown, these guys will have done their practice, and they would have done a lot of set plays with their coach and partner, assuming they have one. Well, we know they both have one. And that's probably why they're playing so electrically well from the off here. This is good doubles. Well, when the Indonesians went on that 9-point tear to get to 14-10, you thought they were going to run away with it, but
wrap it up
from it. Yeah, absolutely. It's been quite a showing from the ranking underdogs here, acquitting themselves very, very well. They've got a slender 1-point advantage. And I wouldn't suggest that it's because the fifth seeds have been underperforming. I just think these two are punching well above their weight right now. Can they keep it up? That's the question.
Once again, here we see how quick he is at the net.
19-17.
Really very, very aggressive.
He's laser-like and live, isn't he? That's gone over the back line as well.
20 game points.
And on the quarter of an hour mark, suddenly, the Thai tandem have a game point. 3 of them.
Hey.
Well, what a turnaround that was. Lost 9 consecutive points through the valley of the game. But it's the Thais, the underdogs, Nitifon Phuangphuapet and Thanaput Viriyangkura that come through 21-17 after exactly 15 minutes played. Well, we've seen it before, haven't we, where a pairing get a good start and multiple times where, you know, a pair take the opening game and then suddenly can't back it up. It's going to be really fascinating to see this team in blue and how they undergo and plot their way through this. But are we going to see the demise of another seeded pairing as we did in the mixed doubles recently?
Please.
Service over, 1-0. Yes, well left by Ardianto.
2-0.
More than I thought, panic might have set in when they lost 9 points in a row in that opening game against the seeded pairing. It's very intimidating, but this man in particular, the 24-year-old, really kept his head. He's the least experienced man on court. We've been talking about that, but it's quite something.
Yeah, they did really well to keep their composure in that opening game. But it's a complete new game here, and you see the Indonesian pair off to a very strong start, 4-love up, and you know, they really have to keep it together now. But so far they've done well, so let's see if they can do it again.
Alfian with gorgeous touch here, and look at the disguise there.
The way he takes off the pace on these kind of shots is really fantastic. He's doing so well.
Six over, 1-4.
But if you can talk about a weaker link in the Indonesian combination, I do think it's Ardianto. And if I was the Thailand combination, I would try to add more pressure on Ardianto if possible. When he's confident, he can play extremely well. But if he's losing a little bit of confidence, then a lot of mistakes are coming from his racket.
What, just gets a little overly aggressive, or
yeah, he's just getting he's just getting nervous by the whole situation. I think sometimes when they play pairs ranked higher than themselves, then you don't see it so much, but you will see it when they're playing pairs that they're expected to win and suddenly it's not going according to plan and so on, then he tends to get a little bit more nervous.
Out. 2, 5.
9, 10. And that's a good follow-up by Viriyankura. Look at how he's attacking straight down the line and he's working his way forward. First one, second one, and look at that. He's so close to the net there. That's a really nice follow-up.
He's certainly not intimidated, that's for sure. Standing his own and some here. And we've not really mentioned his partner, who's been a sort of stalwart of Thai doubles for quite a while. Now, a lot of traffic from the Indonesians going to the younger man, and he was buckled on that occasion.
Yeah, that was not a clever shot cross court.
7-3.
No doubt Alfian was just standing there waiting for it to try to look at this one. That was simply poor quality.
Quickly onto that as well, wasn't he, the 24-year-old?
He was. Didn't fall from that one from Alfian. He wanted to play a soft block shot cross court. Normally a shot that works really well for him, but this time it was completely anticipated.
It's been a match that's going in fits and starts for both teams, isn't it? Both going on generous runs of points somehow.
Well placed. Mid-court area. Always a good shot. Return of serve. Good play at the front there from Phuangphuapet. Look at that interception here. Look at that one. Beautifully done by the very experienced player from Thailand. I can't believe they're 9-8 up. They're really holding up nicely. you look at it from a Thailand point of view.
Absolutely, Morten. I'm kind of disbelieving a little, if I'm honest. Coming in this, into this, I didn't think we had anything like that. I thought the confidence would evaporate very quickly from the men in blue, but not so. They're standing firm, and we've got deadlock here in game two, and they've taken the opener as well. So, well, we could be in for another upset. Still a long way to go, a lot to be played, but this team really playing very, very well. Took to the turn 11-10 in the opening game. I do so again here. He's got a lovely poise and sense of calm around the front court, hasn't he, Alfian?
Yeah, he's one of the very, very best in the game at the front of the court.
So the Indonesians head to the mid-game interval with a one-point advantage. Again, exactly as they did in the opening game. Thais looking a little perplexed as they get in there to their towels. But that's how the land lies. The Indonesians still with work to do. It's a must-win game for them.
Jaga depannya jangan terlalu depan ya. Mundur dikit, mereka mainnya nolong panjang juga. Ayo, come on.
Again, quick to impose himself there in a very intense rally. Well, that could be a big miss. A grimace on the face of the elder Thai athlete, Phuangphuapet. He didn't like that one. Can they recover this deficit? 3 points. That's a start. Never a dull moment in men's doubles, that's for sure. It's just such a quick tempo, this. No nonsense between points either.
Thank you, Super. 12-14.
Fresh shuttle plucked from the dispenser.
Yeah, just 2 points in it. Anything can happen.
Quality return of serve to just consolidate the advantage from Alfian.
Service over. 13-15.
Here we see another one of the small weaknesses in Ardianto's play. His service, you know, when pressure's on again, the service not as strong as his partner's. But this is where he's good, attacking from the back.
Service over. 16-13. Service over. 14-16.
He's making the shuttle talk now, isn't he? He's just so authoritative around the net, Alfian, and he's just got so much in his kit box to hurt you with.
Yeah, he's a good player.
Yeah.
I know I mentioned it earlier, but the day will come, of course, when their partnerships have to change. And, you know, there's been lots and lots of discussion who is Kevin Tsukamoyo going to partner. And a lot of people are talking about maybe it should be Alfian. But the thing is that both of them are front court players. So will they gel? Will it really work out? You never know. And I know, of course, this is into the future, and I wish all the best for Kevin and, of course, partner Gideon in the future.
Service over. 15-19.
Well, they've been on a mission. The intensity has been very, very high, and the consistency up in game two. Here they are on the cusp of drawing level, the Indonesians.
Oh, still getting it back. Good work by Ardianto.
Well, these two still, you have to give them credit. Whatever happens here, they've acquitted themselves really, really well. And you would imagine even better had there been a packed house full of Thai fans. Not so. It's still a great game to watch, nonetheless. But a sense of inevitability, it seems almost unstoppable when they're playing at their best, and they're getting there. Alfian and Ardianto, the fifth seeds, not to be denied. They're going to take this one the distance as well. And we go into a third game very, very shortly.
Women's single, Gregoria Mariska Tanjung from Indonesia.
nggak usah terlalu keras. Kecuali tanggung lo hajar, kagok dia. Ya, tapi kalau ditembak ke kanannya bagus dia. Tembak ke kiri, ke kanan aja.
Kadang-kadang baliknya misalnya kita tembak selang sini, baliknya di sini lagi.
Iya, dia buang fit ya. Siapapun yang di belakang, belakangnya nggak boleh ngesik. Dia masuk panjang aja, hajar inget dia. Ya, satu, dua. Jom kalau di posisi di backhand, emang buangnya jangan lurus, Pak. Batingnya buang silang. Karena dia jaganya lurus terus. Oke.
Kalau sampai men wing, dia men ganti. Kalau ganti di, ganti di ada ช่อง, hidup ada ช่อง เปลี่ยน ทาง. Kalau เมื่อ แก แต้ม ก่อน เมื่อ แก เรา ไม่ มี จังหวะ ที่ แบบ เปลี่ยน ทาง ได้ แต้ม เลย. เห็น ป่ะ เรา ไป รอ ข้าง ล่าง มาก เกิน ไป. ลูก ที่ วิ่ง ไป ข้าง หน้า ถ้า บาง ที ไม่ ได้ ไม่ต้อง ไป ฝืน ถ้า เรา ยิ่ง ฝืน เรา โดน ข้าง หน้า ดัก อีก ไป หลัง พอ ไป หลัง ปั๊บ เตรียม หา ช่อง. ถ้า มี ช่อง หยอด ได้ หยอด.
Mati di sini, tadi bensot, kalau menjepit di
tangan. Jangan buru-buru, oke? Okay. Eh lagi ya, terus saya.
One point one, twenty seconds. Final game, love ball, play.
Here we go then, start of the deciding game here. Who's going to come through this one? Fifth seeds to begin in the men's doubles.
One, love.
Did you see the speed of Viriyankura to recover the court here? Look at this, rapier-like with his movement. He's down, gets back up. Fabulous speed. He's one to watch, I tell you. That was something else.
Yeah, that was good play.
What an athlete. Complements really well with his partner, Phuangphuapet. Both teams desperate to get the early breakaway in this game. Well, we've seen how good he was in defense, and he's not too shabby in attack either. Look at this. Denting the armory of the World 6 pairing.
Three, two.
Yeah, I think the advice to Alfian and Ardianto would be to try to play Phuangphuapet a bit. I know that he's a very good player, and what we see here, the interception of the net is just fantastic. But nevertheless, he's the one of the two players from Thailand that's standing still the most. The other one is really moving around him very quickly, and you never know what's coming from the young one, but you always know what's coming from Phuangphuapet. So maybe, you know, to get into some sort of rhythm and know what kind of shots are coming back, because they played Phuangphuapet so many times prior to this one, then you know, that could be possibly a clever thing. But look at that interception here again of the net. You have to give it to him. Really well played.
Yeah, he's a heavy build, isn't he, in his defence? But he's seeming to read the game very quickly. He was very active there.
He does.
But as you say, his partner's just been a blur, a frenzy of energy. Yeah, intimidatingly so as well. They're blending really well together, Morton. It's fabulous to watch.
They are. Playing well.
Yeah.
Three, five.
Yeah, possibly push Phuangphuapet towards the back of the court. That's what we saw here. That's where maybe the mistakes are creeping in, if you look at it from an Indonesian point of view.
Well, they're really enjoying themselves out here, aren't they? That's for sure. Roaring with delight. They've got a three-point cushion now, the Thais. And look how proactive suddenly Phuangphuapet becomes. He's joining the party. There's no doubting that. The energy of the Thai team right now, they want this badly.
Yeah, but that's again well placed. First backhand and then towards the forehand of Alfian. That's really well played by the young Viriyangkura. Very well played, mixing it up nicely in his attack as well.
Buckling right into the right armpit of more experienced Thai.
Should this third and final game become really close, of course, it will be testing Ardianto towards the end of the game, you know, in terms of keeping it all together and not really buckle under the pressure.
From all four players, but particularly these two, who can kind of almost smell an opportunity here.
Yeah, and very often these kind of opportunities, they arise in the early rounds of a tournament before the players or pairs are really settling into the tournament, and that's where you can see the upsets are usually coming in the first few rounds.
Nine, six.
Well, they haven't managed to get to the mid-game interval first yet, the Thais. Will this be an opportunity for them right here? Just 2 points away from that. Psychologically, that would be a big bolster, a big help for them.
Wonderful, wonderful variation there by Alfian. Look at that, the slice he's opening up with. Come, have a look at this one. That one there, and that's forcing the youngster forward. And then, of course, he cannot defend the next one. Really well played by Alfian. Fantastic variation in his attack.
He's great there as well, wasn't he, with the end range attack, so languid. He's got sort of a champion swagger about him, hasn't he, Alfian? I like it.
Misunderstanding between the two guys.
Big
misunderstanding, and what an opportunity.
Yeah, and a grimace immediately afterwards that said, I can't believe we got that one confused. They almost put a lid on the point.
But I think Viriyankura did the right thing. He was slightly out of balance and couldn't really get to it, and he left it for his partner to move forward. So I think he did the right thing.
10-9.
And once again, we will have an interval with 11-10.
I was just thinking exactly that, you know. Yeah, you read my mind. Well, will it be a third consecutive time in favour of the Indonesians, 11-10? Let's find out. It's such a watchable contest. Tough to pick a winner. Nah, this time it's the ties that get there first. 11-10 in favour of the underdogs, Phuangphuapet and Viriyangkura.
ขึ้นมาตอบจังหวะต้นจังหวะสำหรับสมมุติว่าถ้าเราเสิร์ฟที่สอดไปด้านแบ็คอ่ะพอถ้าไปด้านโฟปั๊บมันคอร์สเลยเตรียมโฟดีๆแต่ถ้าไปด้านแบ็คลูกต่อไปมันจะกลับเข้ากลางพอจับเข้ากลางเตรียมดีๆพอเราแบ็คไปลูกเราต้องเตรียมอยู่บนเตรียมอยู่บนเตรียมที่โฟนไว้ก่อนนิดนึงไม่นานถ้าเราแบบตกใจตีสั้นเลยอย่างเงี้ยโอเคอยู่ฝั่งนี้หาจังหวะเปลี่ยนทางนะอยู่ฝั่งนู้นเราเปลี่ยนทางได้ฝั่งนี้เราเปลี่ยนทางไม่ได้ช่างจังหวะเปล
So here we go then, just about to head down the home straight here. Who's it going to be? Yellow or blue team? Let's find out. Alfian using all of his front court prowess.
Over 12-11.
He's at it again. So alert round the net, Viriyangkura. He's been splendid all day. Now, was that a nervous decision there? It just seemed a little out of kilter with what we've seen so far. And this is sometimes what's happened, isn't it, to a lesser experienced player, Morton. When the finish line appears, nerves can creep in.
You call it scoreboard pressure. I think that's a perfect expression.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh. 13-all.
Oh, it's gone, it's gone. Oh, can you believe it? They worked so hard in defence, didn't they? Only to throw it away there at the net.
Given such a good opportunity, and him of all players at the front of the court, he is so decisive, and this one he's missing.
They did have a 13-11 lead, now a 14-13 lead. It's all getting tight here. Oh. Ties marginally with the upper hand. Can they see it home?
It can be all in the serving. What combination is serving the best?
Brilliant by the Thais, you have to say. So resilient, such determination. Even the coach is fist pumping now, look.
Yeah, let's see if Harry IP from Indonesia, the coach from Indonesia, can find some answers and he can guide his pair to victory here. He's usually very, very good at that. So that's also an option that he can start giving directions from outside the court to say, we have to do so and so in order to win. And you can see he's getting more and more active at the back of the court.
Just an odd moment of faltering from the younger of the two earlier in the game, but nothing so far. They look absolutely, utterly focused and nerveless, the Thais. This is a spellbinding performance for Thai fans here. So far.
They got to it, but did not manage to control it. Phuangphuapet. 15, 16. And now pressure is starting to build up on this serve of Ardianto. So it will be interesting to see this serve can be very, very important. Good serving. That's in, that's in. That's very good serving. Excellent serving. And look at how quickly Ardianto wants to serve. He wants to serve before the opponent is almost not ready. And of course, that's giving him a small advantage. Look at that, how they're delaying it. See, delaying it again.
Got a little tight, Morten, you called it.
Got very tight.
He almost rushed himself, didn't he?
He did. And usually when players are rushing their serves, it's a sign, it's a tell sign that they're not confident on their serve.
Again from the Thais, really enjoying their time here.
Yeah, this match really deserved to have spectators in this stadium to watch this match. and especially a home crowd fan of would be so supported here, wouldn't it?
Yeah, they would have gone nuts, wouldn't they? Oh, well, a slip and a stumble, they still made
he got away with that.
Service over, 18-0.
Deadlock again. Really is no calling this one at all. It's been tight all the way.
Service over, 19-18.
Again, he's been warrior-like, hasn't he? And so gallant, the young man.
And even should the Indonesians win at this point, then it's 19-20. But then Ardianto have to serve. That's a bit of a trick, isn't it? So let's see. Very, very intriguing. That's a good play. That's very good play. Excellent play.
Clever from Ardianto there at the net under a lot of pressure and a big slide mark there for the young Thai, Viriyankura. After that, that'll burn a little.
That will be remembered for a few days.
Yeah, it'll be stinging.
But as I said, now, crunch time on the serve of Ardianto.
Yeah, you can practice serves all you want, but you can't practice under this kind of pressure too often.
See, he's already... See, and that would have been too short.
Yeah.
It's not going to make it any easier now. And he flicked it. That was a clever choice. And poor Phuangphuapet really missed an opportunity here. He had the chance to kill it at the net, but chose to block it.
So match point comes and goes for the Thai underdogs. His partner can barely believe it.
And a second flick serve from Ardianto.
No! Alfian, dominant around the net. Forced the
and
error.
If I'm not mistaken, we will see a third flick serve in a row here from Ardianto. But let's see. Let's see. Third one in a row, but that's really clever by Ardianto. That's good choices, very good choices indeed.
Well, they were Houdini-esque today, weren't they? How did they escape the clutches of the Thais? They saved match point, they turned it around somehow. 17-21, 21-16, 22-20. Well, that was something else. 58 minutes required, just 2 minutes shy of the hour. And the fifth seeds from Indonesia somehow escape and survive to push on to round two. He can't believe it. They will feel utterly relieved after that, that's for sure. Three flick serves in the end from Ardianto. Served them well. Confirmation of the scoreline then, just inside an hour, finding a way through to the W. That's all that matters. And they are through to round two in a very open second quarter of the draw. Indeed, a very open top half.